Hi guys! So if you want to sell your house, pero hindi mo alam kung magkano yung value ng property mo, then that's a bit of a problem. Let's find out how to really know the value of your property, lalo na kung ibibenta mo to. Siyempre, you can hire a licensed real estate appraiser. Pero mas maganda rin if you have a basic knowledge on how to appraise your property. So for today, we are going to discuss two kinds of approaches in property appraisal. So the first one is the cost approach. So usually sa ibang bansa, lalo na sa US and some European countries, they don't separate the value of the lot and the house. Sa cost approach and dito sa Pilipinas, we have to separate the value of the lot and the value of the structure. So first, we have to know the value of the lot. For example, nakatira ka sa subdivision or sa isang village, you have to know the current value of the lot. Meron tayong tinatawag na zonal value, and you can get this from the PIR website. Zonal value are usually lower than the actual market value. And this is not the basis of the current value of your property. So how do you find out the estimated market value? So if there's a resale in your area, ask kung magkano, or kung may property developer pa na nagbebenta ng lots, you can just look for the selling price, the current selling price. In our subdivision, gagawin kong sample yung property namin in Marikina. So we bought it at 6,000 per square meter. Now the current price is around 21,000. Just multiply the lot area by the current price per square meter. So that's 21,000 times 129 square meters. So that's 2.7 million. Ayun yung value ng lot. Now let's go to the value of the structure. So this one is a bit complicated kasi kailangan mo malaman kung magkano na ba magpagawa ng bahay ngayon. So based on our experience, it's ranging from 18,000 to 70,000 depending on the finish. So may low cost, may mid cost, and may high end finish na tinatawag. Let's just say it's, you know, the average mid cost kind type of house. So 27,000 to 30,000. So same thing lang, you just have to multiply the house construction rate by the floor area. So sa amin, 4 floors, 400 square meters times 30,000. So that's roughly around 12 million pesos. So i-add lang natin yung value ng lot at saka yung estimated value ng structure. So 2.7 million plus 12 million. So that is 14.7 million. I know you would say, Chris, you know, our house is not brand new. And that is our next step, which is to calculate the depreciation of your property. So sabi nila, it's around 50 years bago talaga madilapidate yung bahay. So 12 million divided by 50 years, that's 240,000 per year. So 240,000, imumultiply natin kung ilang taon na kayo nakatira sa bahay. So kami, it's around 7 years. 240,000 times 7 years, so that's equals to 1.6 million estimated amount of depreciation. So 12 million less 1.6 million equals 10.3 million. So that's the estimated value of the structure. So dito na natin i-add yung estimated value ng lot at estimated value ng structure. So the total is around 11.9 million. That is close to 12 million. So isara na natin sa 12 million. So dali lang, di ba? So the next approach is also easy. It's called the sales comparison approach. Dito, you just need to know the actual selling prices of the properties in your area. You have to do a research from real estate brokers or real estate agents kung meron silang similar properties gaya nung sayo. So undoubtedly, no property is the same because maybe yung property na kagaya ng property mo, they have improvements. Pinagawa na nila yung kitchen, inayos na nila yung bedrooms. If you think their property is better, you just shave off 5% to 10% and do this per component. For example, if they have a better kitchen, so just shave off 5% until you get the estimated final price. So there you go. Di mo man kailangan ibenta yung property mo, at least may idea ka kung paano mo i-compute yung value ng iyong property. Thank you once again for watching, and kung meron kayong topics na pwede kong discuss in the future, just comment down below. Maraming salamat and have a nice day. Bye!